What is up, everybody? I am back with another shoe review for you. This is another steal and deal, but it's also me breaking down one of my favorite shoe series, the Kyrie Signature series. Now, normally I wouldn't go through an entire series of shoes, mainly because I pick and choose which shoes that I like. A lot of that is because most signature shoes, for me anyway, design-wise and style, they're a hit or miss. Some styles are incredible in the beginning, like the LeBron Zoom Generation or the LeBron 1, but then after probably about the 4, they kind of taper off for me. I'm usually not interested in too many of them. Kind of the same thing with a few of the Kyries, but to be quite honest, I've owned nearly every single Kyrie a part of the series. I owned the one. I loved the Kyrie one because the traction was incredible, especially outside, which is something that you normally don't find from a shoe that for someone's first signature, usually you gotta work out the kinks when it comes to traction, and that this shoe pretty much had it right away. Now, the Kyrie 2, I tried the 2. I thought that the cushioning was really nice. I wasn't the biggest fan of the strap. A lot of that, if you've seen my review of the LeBron 4, a lot of that is because the strap fastens on the medial side of the shoe, which for me, just because of, I guess, how I was born or how I run, I'm constantly hearing the Velcro kind of peeling off because the other shoes are rubbing off on the other one, kind of lifting the strap off of it. Also with that shoe, wasn't the biggest fan of the traction, only because I felt like I could turn over in the shoe, which makes sense for someone like Kyrie, who when you plant for that crossover and you kind of shift your weight, you're gonna lay as much of the medial side of that shoe down on the court, but you're also gonna wanna have some sort of traction so that you can dig to pull yourself back the other direction. So I understood the design, but for me personally, I felt like I was kind of off balance, even though I understood kind of what they were going for. It just wasn't a part of my game. And to be quite honest, with the Kyrie 2 and the Kyrie 3, around that time, KD signatures were starting to kind of come back around, for me anyway, as far as style and design. What they were doing with the 360 cushioning system with KD really kind of led me to that series, just because I was looking for something with more comfort. The Kyrie 3 design and style wise just wasn't for me. Even some of the colorways that came out, some of the really cool colorways, the 3 just wasn't for me. Now when the 4 came out, that shoe for me grabbed my attention immediately. I don't know what it was about the silhouette of this shoe, but it brought me in, or at least it brought me back into the Kyrie series without much hesitation. Personally, you put a gum bottom on any shoe, I'm probably going to want to purchase it. So the Uncle Drew version, kind of coinciding with the release of the movie, it really kind of helped tell that story. But, you know, wearing the shoe, more importantly, I loved almost everything about this shoe. What I would say, I don't know what it is about this particular signature, but I feel like it runs about a half size small. I've got, and I don't know if that could be just with all of the Kyries. We're gonna go through the 4, the 5, the 6. I'm probably gonna end up getting the 7, but this one right here, I loved the sole on this one. And the idea behind this was to help create more flexibility and to create more traction on the floor. And to be quite honest, the traction on these is incredible. I felt that once I went up a half size, that I had plenty of breathing room for my foot. My foot wasn't sliding around. I felt like, you know, with the lace structure, my foot was locked in pretty good. You know, my heel was locked down really well. You've got kind of this back slit here to kind of help with a little, you know, range of motion and flexibility with your ankles, because you got to understand, a player like Kyrie, there's a lot of dancing going on. So there's a lot of range of motion happening with, you know, those ankles. And for me personally, if I remember correctly, I mean, it's just certain shoes remind me of how players played during that time and kind of their style of play. And during that time, man, when Kyrie was wearing these, it was a big thing. It was that transition from Cleveland to Boston. Kind of had, you know, wanted to break out and do his own thing. And I remember a lot of the colorways, like some of the exclusive colorways that were dropping of this signature shoe, were really blowing a lot of people's minds, because they were really taking the signature designs to a whole nother level. And with Kyrie getting so much attention in Boston, that being his first year, his shoes were getting just as much of attention, and rightfully so. So for anyone who's ever had owned hooped in this shoe, you already know what it is. But, you know, leave your comments down below. Let me know what you think about it. Give me your thoughts. Give me your opinions. I'd like to know what you think. This is not my favorite thus far out of the series, but it's definitely up there. If you own any of the Kyries, let me know in the comments below what you think about them. What's your favorite Kyrie? As you guys know, if you know, the 5 is probably my favorite. Well, you know, not only just by performance, but style, design, the different, you know, collaborations. I think the Kyrie 5 really took not only his series, but it really put a little bit of pressure on everybody else to really take their signature to the next level. To be quite honest, I felt like Dame, James Harden, PG, those guys really started to, you know, accelerate the collaborations in colorful colorways and just the different details and designs when Kyrie started to do it, especially with the 5. So, you know, say what you want about Kyrie the person, say what you want about Kyrie the player, but to be quite honest, when it comes to the design and the input he has on his shoes, whatever he's doing over there, he's killing it. Because everywhere you go, whether it be kids, teens, young adults, old adults, you're probably gonna find a Kyrie on the court, which speaks volumes to what those guys are doing over at Nike. So once again, this is a shoe review from your boy. Every shoe that you've seen here, except for the Kyrie 6 Asia, I was able to purchase for under $60. That's what makes me happy, because they're still in wearable condition. I can still hoop in them, and I can get more than $60 worth of wear out of them. I promise you that. If you like the video, like it, subscribe, comment below, let me know what you think. Let me know what kind of videos you want to see next. Got a lot of product reviews, go check those out. I've got some videos with my daughter doing reviews of shoes. Those are great. You can check that out, you know, just for yourself or with your kid. But until next time,